Hello world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. I hope for everyone who's watching this video is that you are safe and healthy in this pandemic period. I am healthy, so I can't complain about that. So let's talk about Azure Sentinel and Threat Intelligence. If I switch over to the Azure portal, you can see I already have a Azure Sentinel workspace open over here. If we go down in the menu, you see that there is a item called Threat Intelligence. And there are a couple of items registered over here. TI indicators, as they are called, Threat Intelligence indicators. We can add new ones of all kinds of types. And if we go to data connectors and search for threat, you see that there are Threat Intelligence platforms over here. And if I go to the analytics rules, check the rule templates and filter on the Threat Intelligence platform connector, you see that there are a lot of template analytics rules available that do something with Threat Intelligence. So as you can see, there is a lot of Threat Intelligence related things in Azure. But what is Threat Intelligence? How can we use it? And how is Azure Sentinel handling Threat Intelligence? So without further ado, let's dive into the first question. What is Threat Intelligence? Threat Intelligence is data left by an attacker after an attack. And it could be an IP address that the attacker used during his attack. It could be file hashes of payloads of malware that he used during his attack, usernames used during the attack, domain names that are used by malware, etc. So here you have an example. This is an attacker that is attacking an environment, and he is using the internet for that. So every TCP package that he is sending to the environment that he wants to attack also has an originating from IP address. In this case, it's the 50.60.70.80 IP address. Now, I have another example for you. Here we have an attacker that is sending a payload to an environment. And a payload could be an executable that contains malware or an executable that contains ransomware or any kind of that stuff. The file hash, which is actually a fingerprint of a file, can be used to identify malware. So the file hash is a type of threat intelligence. So why do we need threat intelligence? Well, first of all, to build better detections. We can use that IP address that you saw earlier to make better detections. For example, if we see a sign in from that IP address, it could be wrong. It could be the attacker. So we can build analytic rules with those data. And secondly, we can use it to identify the attacker group. You often see that an attacker group uses the same file hash as they're using the same type of malware more often. So if we have luck, we can identify an attacker group with it. Well, here's an interesting thing. You see in KQL query over here that you could use as an analytics rule in Azure Sentinel, where we hard code the IP address in the KQL analytics rule query. And that perfectly works on a small scale. But as our analytic rules grow, and so the threat intelligence is growing, it is getting harder to maintain your analytic rule base. So Microsoft has a great solution in Azure Sentinel where they store all the threat intelligence in a threat intelligence indicator table. And I will show you that later. So to work with threat intelligence in Azure Sentinel, we first have to register a threat intelligence connector, the threat intelligence platform connector. And that connector is used to send data to the threat intelligence and then ingest that into the log analytics workspace that is used by Azure Sentinel. And after we have registered the connector, we can add threat intelligence. And we can do that by using PowerShell. We can send REST calls to the Graph Security API, which talks with the Threat Intelligence Platform connector. And we can do it in Azure Sentinel by using the GUI. So without further ado, let's go into the Azure portal and let me show you how you can set up the Azure Sentinel Threat Intelligence connector. And spoiler alert, that is really easy. And after that, I'm going to show you how you can add your own threat intelligence and make use of it. So let's switch over to the Azure portal. Let's go to data connectors, search for threat. And here we have the threat intelligence platform connector, which is used to ingest threat intelligence into your Azure Sentinel workspace. If you scroll down a little bit, you see that I already have it connected. But if you haven't connected it, the only difference in this page is that the blue button here says connect. Click on it and you are done. You have registered the Threat Intelligence Platform connector. So let's go to the Threat Intelligence over here. You see I already have added a couple of threat intelligence items over here. So let's add a new threat intelligence indicator. Let's add an IPv4 address and let's add the 50.60.70.80 address that I used in my example. It is a address that has malicious activity as we saw it earlier during an attack. Seen during a attack, attacker IP address, let's give it that as name. And here we can add the confidence of it. It's a scale from 0 to 100 and let's use 35 for this one. If we go further down, you see we have a valid from date and a valid until date. This is quite important. Just as we are, as defenders are using the cloud, so are attackers using the cloud. So if they go into the cloud using, build a virtual machine, using public IP address by the cloud for their attacking purposes, and after that attack, they are deleting that IP address, the IP address can be easily used by the next person who's going to deploy in a new virtual machine. So it is important to add a valid period to your threat intelligence item to make sure that a IP address is not whitelisted for the rest of its entire life. Because an IP address can have a new life after that it's being used by the attacker. So let's say that it's valid from today. We have a validation of about 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. It's created by me. Let's click on apply. So the threat intelligence indicator is being added to Azure Sentinel right now. So and before I show you how you can use threat intelligence in your analytics rules to make awesome detections, let's first create a good cup of coffee, because we can't have a Azure Vlog without coffee, right? Coffee in Azure, you can't get enough of them. Ah, that's nice. As I said earlier, threat intelligence is stored in a table that's in your log analytics workspace. The table is called a threat intelligence indicator. So if I switch back to the Azure portal, I have a query explorer over here, and we can limit 100. We can investigate the table by running the query threat intelligence indicator, and you see that I have three items over here, and that corresponds with the three items that you saw earlier. Let's click on what we have over here. And here we have a domain name, a really bad domain.org. And here we have another domain name, baddomain.com. Let's check this one. This is the IP address that we created earlier on. So data added in the threat intelligence pages in Azure Sentinel will end up in your threat intelligence table in Azure Sentinel. And that's quite nice, because with the Kusto query language, the KQL query language, we can do joins. And if I join, for example, my Azure activity, we have a caller IP address over there with my threat intelligence indicators table, and I join them on the IP address column, we can get results of Azure activities that are executed with the IP address that is in my threat intelligence indicator table. So let's switch over to the Azure portal and build that analytics rule. And we want to start with the Azure activity table. We want to join it by using a inner kind joiner. That means that the IP address needs to be available both in the Azure activity table as well as the threat intelligence table. And we want to join it on the left side, the caller IP address, and on the right side, I want to use the network IP address, as you saw earlier on. If I run this query, well, there is no result as I don't have attacked my environment using that IP address. But believe me, this query will work. So let's now build an analytics rule that's using the query that we designed earlier on. So we have a analytics rule that is able to trigger alerts when an Azure activity happened on an IP address that already is registered as threat intelligence. Let's switch over to the Azure portal. Let's go to analytics rules. Click on create. We want to create a scheduled query rule. Let's give it a name. Azure activity executed by TI IP address. The description, I will leave it empty for now. With the tactic, let's go to rule definition. I've copied my query when I designed it, so I can easily paste it in over here. So for now, we'll not map any entities, but as you can see over here, these are items which could later end up as threat intelligence if all your security processes are working awesome. And I want to run this query every 5 hours and look back for the data set that's been generated for the past 5 hours. And if the amount of alerts created is bigger than zero, it will create an incident. I will not group anything. I will not enable any automated response. And the analytics rule is created. Bam! So it's that easy to create an analytics rule that makes use of threat intelligence. But wait, Jeroen, earlier you said that there's also a possibility you to send data to the threat intelligence table by using PowerShell. And I've created a GitHub gist for that. Let me show that to you. If I switch back to my display, I already have it open over here. I will put the link of this gist in the description of this video, so you can view it easy by yourself. And what it's doing, it's authenticating to the Graph API, and it's using the security graph part and add some domains over here. In this case, it's the domains of the SolariWinds attack that happened a couple of weeks ago, and uses a for each loop to add them all together. So that could make your life much more easy. So during this vlog, you learned what threat intelligence is, what types of threat intelligence items you have, for example, the domain names, IP addresses, file hashes, etc. You saw how we can set up the threat intelligence connector in Azure Sentinel, as well as how we can create threat intelligence by using the Azure portal. And you learned how Azure Sentinel works with threat intelligence. It's stored in a separate table, and we can use joins to detect if our threat intelligence is used in activities and logs that we also have connected to Azure Sentinel. For example, we can see if a activity in Azure is executed by an IP address that is reported earlier as threat intelligence. I hope this will make your environment a little bit more secure. So with that, please subscribe to this channel if you like this type of content. Also, click on the bell to get a notification once I've created a new video. And of course, I'll see you in the next vlog. Bye!